the fifth and the sixth grades, and the seventh and the eighth grades. The quote that they are going to discuss is, leave a little sparkle wherever you go. We wish everyone good luck, and we will start with Bocsok Alexandra from the fifth grade. Are you ready, Alexandra? Good luck.
Hi, my name is Alexandra, and I'm here to tell you some of my ideas of how to leave a little sparkle wherever we go. Firstly, we have to smile to other people, because if you smile to other people, they'll be happy, and they'll smile to you too. This makes you happy and feel better. You have to be yourself, because if you show your true personality, your friends will trust your advice, and you have to do what you feel when you are in trouble. A little compliment can change a long day for a person, and this can make you feel happy and we have to help how much we can, because if you help the people in need, they'll be happy to stay around you, and they'll show their true personality too. You have to be positive, because the other people will be happy, and this can change your day and their as well. All in all, I think all of us are little sparkles, and depends on us to change this world and make good deeds. Now I have a little song from Katy Perry called Firework. In her song called Firework, we have to let our lights shine and colors burst till they go up. Thank you.
Thank you. Leonte Malina is next.
Hi, I'm Ariana Grande. You might have heard of me. They say I'm one of the biggest pop stars in the world. The last few years have been the most successful years of my career. I won many awards, I released 2 number one albums, and I've been voted Woman of the Year. You might say, wow, this woman has it all, money, fame, and happiness. But you are wrong. As I started to get more successful and famous, I felt like I was losing a part of myself. I felt like I was losing the sparkle filled with joy and happiness that made me love what I do. I started singing because I wanted to share my talent with others, but others seem not to enjoy my music as much as I do. Of course, I have my fans, my loves, my Arianators that I love from the bottom of my heart, but there are also haters that seem to enjoy making fun of me. My family and friends tell me that I should not focus on what others say and that I should stay positive. But I'm really grateful to have them by my side. Sometimes I wish I can go back to doing impressions of Mariah Carey and Whitney Houston in the kitchen with my brother for my grandma and grandmother to enjoy. Back then I felt a very powerful sparkle filled with happiness and good vibes. But right now I feel like I only have the sparkle with those happy memories. As I got more fame, I started feeling more anxious, but after the Manchester attack at my concert, everything has changed. 22 souls died because they wanted to see me live. They were fans of me. And I know people say I shouldn't feel guilty, but I do. After that, I felt like I lost my sparkle forever. But a few months ago, I started my tour again. And just seeing the happy faces of my fans when I hopped on stage, when I met them, made me feel like I can be happy again and help me find my inner sparkle. So I decided to say thank you next to those bad vibes and to focus on the little things in life, like dancing on 5-inch heels on stage, or singing for my Arianators, or laughing with my friends and family. A thing my fans taught me is to leave a little sparkle wherever I go, so maybe that way I can help other people find themselves too, how my fans helped me, and we can make the world a better place. Thank you.
Monandra, are you ready?
Hi, I'm back home. Is anyone here? Oh, there's a box, I think. There's a photo of my grandma and a letter. I think I should read it. Oh, leave a little spark wherever you go. That's interesting. Leave a little spark wherever you go. I always try to leave a little spark wherever I go. It's important, but sometimes you focus to make a good impression. But it is not only about that. When you go somewhere, you try to make a good impression and to be someone that you're not. Like, yeah, I go to theater and I only listen to classical music. But when you go back home, you put your t-shirt on, turn the TV on, and leave on the couch. Try to make things true. Always tell the truth. It's better. Anyway, that's not the meaning of the sparkle. To leave a little spark wherever you go means that you should try to make things as well as good. help people. Try to teach everyone good things. Shut people with a gun full of love, happiness, good vibes, and reality. Because reality is the most important thing. Don't try to be like others, because they enjoy their lives, they do important things, and you just look at them. So be your own detective. See what you have to do better in your life. Create your own sparkle and shine as much as you can. Because one day you will have to be yourself and to live your own life. Try to help people and to leave a little of you wherever you go. Because each people you will meet will be a part of you and will help you one day. So admit that life is not pink and will not live happy ever after. So do something about that. Because if you don't leave a little spark wherever you go, then who will? With love, Grandma. Thanks.
Sunziana Vrânceanu, are you ready?
Hi, I'm 11. I know I've got a strange name, but when I was born, some people from the Hawkins lab kidnapped me and they wrote on my hand 011. And this is my name, apart from my real name, Jane Eves. Now, my name is 11 Hopper and my friends call me Elle. When I escaped from the lab, Mike, Dustin, and Lucas brought me to Mike's home, where he hid me, giving me a couch. When they realized I can use the power of my mind, they realized I can help them to find Will Byers, who has kidnapped by the monster created by mistake in the Hawkins lab. The monster, renamed by the boys Demogorgon, brought Will in the Upside Down. At first, Dustin and Lucas weren't happy with the idea of me joining their squad because they believed I was a weirdo. But later, some bullies from the boys' school prompted Mike to jump off a rock. When he jumped, I picked him up with my mind from the ground and I dismissed the bullies. Dustin and Lucas were proud of me and we became friends. Later, the boys' parents, Will's mother, Sherry Hopper, and their friends met me and they made more hopes of finding Will. Nancy, Mike's sister, and Jonathan, Will's brother, created a trap to capture the Demogorgon. Unfortunately, they fall. The monster escaped and he headed for the middle school from Hawkins. Mike, Dustin, Lucas, and I headed for the school to kill the monster, and later I used my superpowers to kill the Demogorgon. Then I said goodbye to Mike. This is my story. I hope I left a good impression of people by saving their town from a monster which kidnapped people, because this is my motto. Leave a little spark wherever you go.
Vasilescu, Maria.
In the past years, the world has been filled with negative energy from all these new devices that people have invented. All these new high-tech gadgets have filled our world with ignorance towards one another. We begin to notice and appreciate less and less the effort that people put into giving us our day-to-day life things. But we don't have to. You may think that those kids who stay all day on their phones and have the latest gadgets on the planet are unsavable and cannot be taken off them. But you are wrong. Those kids can use their phones and their knowledge of technology to better the world. But how? Well, for example, they can post on social media this simple but effective phrase. Lift your head from your phone and look around. Because by looking around, you can acknowledge the little things like trees, animals, and other people. And in time, you will start to acknowledge the bigger things, like the effort people put into growing us fruits and vegetables, or working a 9-to-5 job just to keep the economy safe and stable, and try to make sure everyone has food and a roof over their heads. But what can you, as a grown adult, do to better the world? Well, you can volunteer at an animal shelter or at an old foster care. If you lift your head from your phone, you can see that other people who are still looking at their phones walk around without looking where they're stepping or crossing roads without checking both sides. Those people can get to the hospitals with major injuries. So if you see these people, help them. Don't ignore them, because if you do, you will be no different from the ones that are still looking on their phones. And guys, trying to make the world a better place here, right? Yes. So don't ignore the ones that need to be awakened or laugh at their faults, but help them and make them realize the errors of their ways. Be helpful towards others, and by being a better person, you will for sure make the world a better place. So get out of your bubble. Maybe others will too. Thank you.
Ok. Noaghi? Ariana Noaghi.
Hi, I'm the fairy of good deeds, as old as the world. As are 7 days in a week, 7 continents or 7 wonders of the world, there are 7 sparkles I have to power to give to people, so the world around them becomes a better place. When children fall ill, I am the one to send one of the schoolmates to the sick child's home to give him the schoolwork he missed, but also attention and affection to make them feel better. This is called kindness. When the poor or the orphan are starving for food or affection, I am the one who gives the richer or the one with a loving family the power to be charitable, both materially and emotionally. This is called generosity. Whenever some of us are lonely and have no friends to talk to, there will be always someone to notice the sadness in their eyes and go over, talk, listen to, and become friends with them. This is called empathy. If you feel unaccepted and want to become like someone else, a popular person, you will imitate their behavior, their way of speaking or dressing. But this person won't be you. It will be a false image of yourself. I will grant you the power to be yourself because you're unique and special in your own way, and this is priceless. This is called honesty. Are your opinions sometimes hard to digest for the others? Are you afraid to speak out and stand by your beliefs? I will give you the power to support your views, no matter what, because the greatest changes in the world happen when one person stepped out and their opposed idea of the masses. This is called bravery. You may think education in Romania is good for you, but your best friend thinks that England is the best choice for study. Don't argue with his opinion. Talk and respect what others have to say, because we are not the same and differences are what make our world beautiful. This is called respect. When working in a team, all the members have to put the same amount of work in order to get the same amount of price. Otherwise, I can give you the power to give recognition to the others and be fair in everything you do. This is called fairness. So, I have magic powers, and many of you would like to be me, or like Superman or Spider-Man. But mark my words, the seven sparkles are your superpower, and if you show at least one of them, you will mean so much more to people. You will be their personal hero.
Gheorgheaș Maria Denisa.
I have been a doctor for almost 15 years, and I could give a long professional speech, but I think I could not make you realize that I have left something and I will leave something behind. Yes, I can say my entire successful career. I don't think that my job is only about the human body, but also about the heart. No, I'm not a cardiologist, but my profession, in fact, the profession of every doctor, I think is about the soul, about every feeling and emotion felt by every child, about the states and feeling that the child experiences when he finds out he is, well, sweetie, as I like to call them when I discover another child who fights the same fights as me, with type 1 diabetes. In fact, the struggle would not be with diabetes, but with himself, because you are more sensitive than the other sweeties. In the soul of such a child, there is a struggle of acceptance of himself and of the fear of acceptance in society. Often, we seem strong. Our soul carries a whole fight. This is not about not being able to eat too much sweet food. Often, this is a good part. But about the fact that you have to have your injections daily, that you will lose hundreds of billion blood drops to test your blood sugar, that you will have to calculate a certain amount of carbohydrates. Yes, you can say that I am crying. That is not a disease. You can live very well. And now the technology was evolved, and I think we evolved, making life easier. But we are sweet. We are fragile, like some snakes, like snowflakes. That we even though we are sensitive inside, we prove that to never stop and go ahead. At first, I see the fear they have on their face, but I try to explain it is not impossible. But first, it will be difficult. But their life goes on, maybe even better. Continue to make beautiful moments with your loved ones as well. I tell them it was hard for me at first. I won't ever eat. I have had wonderful moments, and since this is my job, Charles and me. And now I try to become an inspiration for others. That is what I think is mean to leave a little spark wherever you go, to do something meaningful, to become an inspiration for others. For others. I think each of us should make his own fight a motivation for those around him. Thank you.
cred că în Mara.
As you must know, I'm traveling a lot with the circus because I'm a parrot. I usually do magic tricks and I make people happy, but I don't feel free. I remember that once I tried to escape, but Morris, my magician, grabbed me and put me back in my cage. He held me and I was really, really scared. He got so angry that he didn't feed me for one whole day. Next to 3 months from that horrible event, I tried to escape again, and this time my plan worked. For the first time in my life, I actually felt free. It was the most wonderful feeling I had ever had. I didn't know what to do at first. There were so many new things for me. My first week in a whole new world was amazing. But then I started to feel lonely, so I tried to find a friend. It was hard for me because those birds weren't very kind to me. I traveled a lot until I found a small town that was very similar with the village from the story with the beauty, the simple girl, and the beast. I was flying near people that seemed to be nice to see if they let me stay around, but no one did. I was very sad and hungry that day until an old man made me a sign to come to him, so I did what he told me. We went to his house. There were a lot of flowers, and the house was small and pretty. He gave me some food and showed me a place where I could sleep. The next days, I was still staying at Arthur's house. I also found out about him that once, when he was younger, he was a magician, so I showed him some tricks I had learned at the circus. I saw a big smile on his face. From that day, I started doing magic tricks with Arthur again. For the first time in my life, I was making people happy, and I was also happy. Wherever I went with Arthur, I left people a smile on their face, until I discovered that I was sick. At every show I had, some of my feathers were falling, and little children were taking them and putting them in their hair. Even if Arthur took the disease, my feathers were still falling. But I was happy because I had a great life with Arthur, and I also let people a smile on their face and a sparkle in their hearts. Thank
the seventh grade. Are you ready? Yes? Okay. We will start with Bratu Horia, then Kitsu Darius, Ducaru Ioana, Rucăreanu Mara, Jigmon Cristian, and Iankish Iulia. Bratu Horia is now going to delight us with his monologue.
I am Rosa Parks. I'm your average black lady in 1955. I work as a social rights activist, fighting for my rights, for the rights of the black community. On the 1st of December, 1955, I was going home on a bus with three other ladies. There are special seats for us black people, yes, but the bus was full. See, the law was that if a white person came up to us and asked us to give him our seats, as black people, we had to do it. That was the law. This white man came up to us and demanded that we give him our seats. But I refused, and I stood up for myself. Long story short, I was arrested. On the day of my trial, 1955, the 5th of December, an all-day bus boycott was organized as a sign of protest. I was found guilty and charged $15. 1 year later, the court decision supported the end of racial segregation on buses. I was proud of what I've done. If I wouldn't have done all of this, I wouldn't have left a spark behind. We would have lived in a different world. Greetings, everyone. I am Harriet Tubman. I don't have a wonderful background. I was a slave to a white family. I always felt so sad and lonely, especially when I was separated from my mother. I was sick and tired of slaving around, being beaten and whipped like I was nothing. After all, I was human too. I had a decision to make, a hard one. Very dangerous, full of risks, but I was sure about it. On the night of 1849, I escaped my master's house and ran away to Philadelphia. After days of fear and worrying that I was going to get caught, I was finally free. Yet, something felt empty. I was a stranger on strange lands. Yes, I was free, but my siblings, my mother, my father aren't, and they should be too. I had yet another dangerous decision to make. I was going back. Traveling through the cold and misty nights, I was never caught. I ended up rescuing over 70 slaves with no passengers left behind. I was nicknamed She Moses and was also the first woman to command a troop in the Cold War. I'm very proud of what I've done. If I wouldn't have done all of this, I wouldn't have left the spark upon people's lives. What you just heard were some examples of how people left sparks behind wherever they went. Imagine that in times so hard, such as slavery and living in an apartheid, these people still left a message that brought light upon people's lives. It's not really that hard to understand what human spirit and courage is able to achieve. I would like to end this monologue with a quote by Nelson Mandela. And as we let our own light shine, we unconsciously give other people permission to do the same. And as we're liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. Thank you.
Darius Chițu. Good luck.
What is a legacy precisely? Well, it's something left behind, whether it is a material or immaterial, that doesn't matter, that somebody leaves behind after they've passed. Now, a legacy is important because it's an artificial solution to try to prolong our existence, to create a memory of us. Because if one was a great person, if one wouldn't have a legacy, then his values would be lost, and it is a way to conserve and preserve the ideas and the person. In another way to look at a legacy is that it's scary, first of all, to be forgotten. To be forgotten is to not exist in a memory. And if we would bring that to an absolute, it would be the following question: what is it like to not be remembered by anybody? This answer may seem a bit sad, but it's true. It's like being dead. Because the thing with that is that you are no longer alive, really. And it's the second and the last stage of you leaving this earth and everything you stood for. Now let's look at humans, as us, the species Homo sapiens. We've got this thing known as consciousness, which is the thing which separates us from the animals and from the pets that we have. It's a thing that says that we are aware that we exist and that we have an end and a beginning. Now, consciousness generates this yearning for eternity, infinity, and most of all, meaning. So life now is scary because death is the sentence that says life should be finite. So now this shatters the dream of an eternal life. We have this dichotomy between reality, which is the finite life, and the ideal, which is the eternal life. This is why gods were created, to try to personify the eternal life, to make something similar to us so that we would be more comfortable in this scary world. Now, because life is finite, some people have tried to answer the following: should life be finite or infinite? I propose the following thought experiment. If you'd like, please close your eyes. Imagine a string of positive integers going 1, 2, 3, and 4. I want you to try to find the end of that string. Once you try, you will realize that you really can't, because there's always going to be a number greater than the last one. So we cannot find the end of the string. It's undefined, as the string is infinite. Now look at life as the string. If life would be eternal, then there would be no undefined end. And knowing that there are a finite amount of things to do, at one point we will inevitably do everything that was possible to do. And life in that point will lose meaning. And the first thing that all of us humans want in life is to have a meaning. And as such, the model of an eternal life would be inherently flawed, and as such, the finite life is much better. So life should be finite, and it is. And it's like a road. We shouldn't look at it as an end destination. We should concentrate on the road that was going from point A to point B. The same thing is with legacies. They shouldn't be necessarily forced. They should be accumulated over a large amount of time, doing good deeds, doing good ideas, and coming up with things that will make what is you and what will be you in history. If we'll focus on that and not necessarily on at the end destination, and we'll try to do what is best, then you will realize that you may become one of the greats. And you will be remembered for what you are, as such, advancing humankind on this road that is life.
Ducaru Ioana. Good luck.
What's a fairy? What can she really do? As I'm thinking of fairies, my mother's voice still sounds in my mind. I remember the moment when she started to read to me the childhood stories such as Pinocchio or Cinderella. What inspired me so much was the fact that a fairy is always with a magic sparkling wand in her hand, and she appears surrounded by millions of stars. She gives the sparkle for an undiscovered but pure heart. I admire these creatures, and I've been always dreaming to be a fairy, and I want my dream to become true. I have a friend, Anne. She's quite popular on Instagram. She's beautiful, charming, and she has big blue eyes. Also, her parents are rich, and she wears clothes from the most popular brands. She knows how to smile to look good in a photo, but I know that she isn't happy. She's always proud of her material things she can show off with, but she never talks about her feelings. Once, I told her that what matters in life are her spiritual values, not the material ones. But Anne didn't listen to me. Now I am riding my horse in the forest. The wind blows through my hair, caressing me. This reminds me of a summer riding camp in the middle of nature. Me and my friend were very happy for the opportunity of spending time together. But when I was talking to some people, Anne suddenly screamed. She finally realized that was no internet in the middle of nature. First, she was very sad, but then she became angry. She started shouting and blamed everybody for the lack of internet and horsey smell. She refused to ride anymore because, as she said, nothing is important if you cannot share it on the net. What am I supposed to do? I was thinking. I tried to help her socialize or at least take part in some activities. I went outside to play with the other kids. We jumped, danced, played hopscotch, and played with a ball. But Anne didn't want to join us. One night, she told me that she heard someone screaming in the forest, and no one else heard it. I'm happy I'm able to save people when they need, so I persuaded her to come with me. We found one little boy crying under a tree. He was sad and scared. We took him to the camp. He told us that while he was walking in the forest, the wind started blowing and the noise of the branches terrified him. That moment, Anne realized that we saved the boy's life, and she smiled with her soul for the first time. I was fulfilled because I was holding the fairy's wand. Now, Anne is helping other people smile in a volunteering campaign. She's truly happy. That night, I was a fairy and I helped my friend to discover herself. She smiled and her spirit's light started to glow. This will accompany her on her way. Now, she's also a fairy. I'll always remember that the most beautiful makeup is smile. It's the most powerful weapon against all of the hardships of life. And the best drug is kindness. It is found in our hearts. Once discovered, each of us becomes a fairy. It's nice to help people and give them a small part of yourself. All you have to do is to leave a little sparkle wherever you go. Thank you.
Rucăreanu Mara, good luck.
We all have creation, imagination, and our own ideas. That's why I was trying to teach my friend Lily. She was a smart girl. She had good grades. She was going to a very, very good school. But the problem is she didn't think about the grades or teachers, if the teachers like her or not. She only wanted to be popular and to be surrounded by people and friends. Well, she was really sad and think that her life is awful because she has no friends and she is just a normal girl. One day she came to me and said, well, why I can't be popular? Why I can't be a girl that when someone says, wow, that girl is amazing, I love her. And I said to her, but you are. You are, for me you are something special. But she didn't listen to me and said, you don't support me, I don't need you anymore. So time passed and she wanted more and more to be popular. So she didn't talk to me anymore, she said, I'm not a good friend. But one day when her mom came to her and to take her from school, she started to cry and said, mom, why I can't be popular, why? And her mom said, when I was young, I had the same problem. I wanted to be something that I am not. But then I realized that the only thing that I have to do is to be myself and to try to inspire people by doing things that I like and doing things that I can do. So Lily started to do this, and she every day when she went to school, she said hi to people, she participated in a lot of competitions, and she had a lot of friends now. And she was like, and she said, well, popularity doesn't mean to be surrounded by people and to inspire them. And I like this because She became my friend again, and she said that she likes to inspire people and to know that the people like her not just because she has good clothes and she has good posts on Instagram, and because she can do things that no one can do and she do things just in her own way. So like this, wherever she goes, someone remember about her because she always leaves a sparkle wherever she goes. Thank you.
Zsigmond Christian.
So,
good luck.
Imagine, you are in a bus and all the people stay upset because they're busy and they're very, very, very tired. All their faces are sad. If you make like them, you'll be sad too. But you need to smile and leave a little spark right there to make the bus feel better and all the people inside him make feel happier. It's just a little thing you should do if you want to be a better person. Another example is you are in the school and your classmate is very angry, but you can smile at him and show him that if you're happy, you'll do better in anything you do. That's the thing. If we don't smile, we will become robots. They're only hardworking and doing nothing with their lives. If you keep everywhere, forever smiling, and everywhere you go, you smile to each other, you will discover that all those bad things are not so bad. You can feel released. And that's why you need to leave a little sparkle wherever you go.
Yankish Yulia. Good luck.
Thank you. Have you ever thought about that strangers have their lives and experiences? Of course you have. That's a stupid question on my part. But think about it. When you pass by strangers on the street, you don't think about them as persons necessarily. You think them as objects that move through your life. And I think we should be a bit aware of that. We influence everyone that we meet. We may not think about it, but we do. When a stranger smiles at you and is kind to you, sometimes it makes your day, but when they're rude and they tear you down, it ruins your day. That's when I decided I wanted to change the world, my world. Everyone wants to be the hero, but not everyone can be a doctor, a fireman, or a scientist. But we can change our world. We don't need to save the whole world. We can change ours. We need to understand that sometimes the little things matter the most. Smile more, be kind to people, help those in need. Because when you need it, I believe in karma, that's going to return to you. Those who you are kind to won't necessarily remember you. But why do we need to live to be remembered? Live for your sake, not for others' sake, because how you'll be remembered won't affect you. How you live will affect you. That's why I think we should change our lives for better, to be happier, and maybe you'll be remembered as a great person. That's important, not what you did. Now, I don't say that let's stop creating things because that's not realistic. But try to make yourself happy and through that make others happy. Thank you.
Congratulations. Have a nice day. Goodbye.